You can buy stocks from the firm itself or from other investors. The first case arises when a firm wants to raise capital. In this case, the firm issues new shares and sells them to investors. For example, suppose a firm has a single owner, perhaps the founder of the firm, and that she has 10 shares. The firm issues 5 new shares and sells them to an investor. In this case, the number of shares outstanding, that is the number of shares held by all of the firm shareholders, increases from 10 to 15, and the firm collects the amount paid by the investor. To illustrate the second case, consider the firm just described, with a single owner holding 10 shares. Imagine that this shareholder needs cash or wants to sell some of her shares for whatever reason. She sells 5 of her own shares to an investor. In this case, the number of shares outstanding does not change. It's still 10. And the amount paid for the shares ends up in the bank account of the original shareholder. Indeed, this transaction does not involve the firm at all. The majority of the trading activity that happens every day in the New York Stock Exchange, NASDAQ, or any of the international stock exchanges is like the second type I described here. But now, how much will this investor pay for the stock? We will spend the rest of the module talking about this question.